Dubnyk stops it behind the net. Lattimore playing it. Left it there. Comes back to Brody. Just kept it onside. Here's Versteeg with a bit of a touch to the middle. Feeds it in the circle. It's goal! Tipped in front. Chase on with the redirection. And it's 1-0 Calgary.
This is all about puck support. Chris Versteeg does a fantastic job. The puck is going to come back to TJ Brody. It's rolling, and he doesn't have many options. So Versteeg comes up about 10 feet away, gives him the outlet. And there's a fantastic quick release from Bennett. No hesitation. But give Versteeg all that credit for making that outlet pass available to TJ Brody. If not, basically, Brody would have just had to have dumped it back down behind the net.
Tkachuk to the line, Hamilton. Watched by Coyle as he centers. And a deflected shot by Tkachuk is covered by Dubnyk. And then drops it off for Johnny Gaudreau. Gaudreau feeds it across on the right wing to Brouwer. Up front for Gaudreau, tip of the ball, rebound, he scores! Sean Monahan on the power play makes it 2-0 Calgary.
Once again on the power play, it's all about their entries for the Calgary Flames and then options. So the bump back from Brody gives it to Gaudreau. Gaudreau goes right to the front of the net. Early deflection. And finishes it because Devin Dubnyk, of course, has to be honest with the deflection from Gaudreau. Monahan comes in. Monahan now scores 7 goals in his last 9 games. He's on fire.
They cannot turn this into a trade chances situation, or they'll find themselves on the other side of the score.
Granlund has Zucker with him into the Calgary zone. Granlund, center, Zucker scores! And the Wild right back in it. It's 2-1.
Case in point. The Wild have the ability to turn offense back the other way. And when you get guys that know how to jump into the play, watch. Look at Spurgeon supporting right here. Just being part of the play, that means that there's just another guy to have to keep your eye on. But we've seen this combination so many times. Granlund knows that if he gets it over to Zucker, that baby's going into the net. Zucker changed this summer, changed the lie on his stick, a little bit more upright of a lie, which gives him a higher posture in his skating stride, which gives him maybe a little even more speed.
Giordano out to center, Versteeg with it for Calgary. Back to Bennett, Bennett fires, saved by Dubnyk. And Koivu clears for Minnesota.
Very good save there because Bennett did the pull and drag move, waited and waited, and finally was able to get the puck.
He's only 22 years old.
Spurgeon shot. Elliott save. Loose puck. Where is it? Caught up in Elliott's gear long enough for a whistle. 25th save of the night for Brian Elliott.
And those are always difficult because you're trying to put the rebound out to the corner. The puck was deflected though along the way, and so that gave Elliott all sorts of problems. There's the traffic in front just to his right. How often do we see that? Goaltender tries to put the rebound to the corner, goes off the traffic and in the net.
Backlund along the wall, down low, Tkachuk. Try to drag one back between his legs. Dubnyk holds his ground along the post. Hamilton finds Backlund at the half wall. Backlund. Cross ice, Giordano. Centers, Tkachuk got a piece of it, and then Dumba swept it away. Giordano centers, Koivu sends it the length of the ice.
This is gonna have a great finish.
33 seconds left in the power play. Brody, Weidman, the high slot to Monahan. Monahan shoots, scores! What a shot by Sean Monahan. Second power play goal of the game, and the Flames are back on top by 2.
Right from the faceoff. And good work by Brouwer to get back to the point. But take a look at Brouwer as well. Go right to the front of Dubnyk. take away his vision. And it was interesting, after the puck went in the celebration, oh, that puck hits Brouwer in the arm. You could see that after the celebration, Brouwer skated towards the Flames bench, but kind of towards Dubnyk as well, and had some words after that little confrontation that they had earlier.
I think it might go off Dubnyk's arm, Kelly.
Is it Dubnyk's?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. So we'll see. And it is Monahan's goal. One of the replays, Kelly, did look like it deflected off Brouwer's shoulder. But you're right about Monahan. Boy, is he going now for the Flames. Englund shoots, scores! That may have been tipped, but right off the draw, the Flames make it 4-1.
So Flames doing a couple things that are allowing them to have success. Fight hard on faceoffs, winning those back to the point, and get bodies. You can see there's four layers of bodies that Devan Dubnyk has to look through. And that's just good puck retrieval from the Flames. On the faceoff, Derek Englund recognizes lots of traffic. And in fact, I think you're right, Rick. I think there's a deflection along the way. Once again, very difficult to tell, but might have hit a stick.
Perlin makes the able to check in and works it out the center, 2-on-1 with Boma. Perlin and Boma. Michael Perlin scores! Well, we thought he might have tipped the last one. No doubt about that one. Perlin gets the goal. It's 5-1 Calgary.
Mike Riley, the defenseman for the Wild, trying to create some offense, so he comes down low and ends up losing a stick right there. That allows this 2-on-1 to develop. And wisely, Perlin just going to shoot the puck. But this is just an example of the Wild trying to create some offense, down 4-1, leading to a 2-on-1. Boy, the fourth line for the Flames has been really effective tonight in all sorts of different areas, and not just because they've scored.
Perlin gets his seventh, has goals in back-to-back games.